In this lesson, we are going to scaffold the activities of a supplier on the show screen. We'll see in detail all the work the OutSystems platform has saved you with this operation. Let's start by creating a new entity, and I'll call this supplier activity. And the idea is that for any relevant event that occurs for a supplier, that we store in this entity that information. So I'll need to add a couple attributes here to indicate for which supplier, so supplier ID, and also to indicate the instant and a description of this event. Now, all these attributes are going to be mandatory. This one, the instant is going to be mandatory, and I want to set the default value to be the current date time. And the description is going to be mandatory, and I want to set it to 250 characters long. Now, next step will be to scaffold the list of activities on the supplier show page. So let's go into the supplier show page. And we're going to scaffold the master detail list. And we're going to do this by dragging the relation entity, so the supplier activity entity, into the show screen. And this creates a list of records and adds all the functionality to support managing the master detail relationship. So let's go ahead and do this. Drag and drop the supplier activity into the show screen right below the show record, and you'll notice the visual hint with the stars that this will create a supplier activity table. Let me just drop it here, and there we have it. So it has a title, supplier activities, it has a table records that shows the instant and the description of that event that I was talking about, and it has here a couple of actions to add an activity, so new supplier activity, which is actually a pop-up. We're going to see more details about this further ahead. And it also has another action to delete the selected activities. And for that, we have a checkbox on the table records. Before going into the pop-up that was just created, let's see what changed in the supplier show page. On the preparation, we have a new query to get the activities of the supplier of this page. And we also have the action that goes through the list of activities, checks which ones are selected, and deletes them from that list. And finally, we need to check the pop-up for this action here, for the new supplier activity. And this pop-up includes an edit record to fill in the instant and the description. I'm actually going to remove the instant from here, because we added the default value for this attribute in the entity. So let me just remove it. And basically, this will serve to add a description. And the supplier ID that we also need for this master detail is provided as an input parameter, and it's used in the save action. It's used to set that value on the edit record. And the logic that you see here is pretty much what you expect. So it creates an activity and it notifies, this is a pop-up, remember, it notifies the parent so that the list here on the supplier show is refreshed. So let's see all this in action and publish our application. Okay, so let's navigate to the show screen of Abbott Laboratories. And there we have our list. It's empty for now. So let's create our first supplier activity. And let's say that the description is that signed new contract. And you notice that we have a save for this action. We also have the pattern to save and add a new record. This will keep the pop-up opened. So let's try that one, sign new contract. And there you have it, the feedback message, the list was refreshed, And let's add another one and say that new contact John Darrow. And let's save. And the pop-up was closed, the feedback message, and the list was refreshed. And we can go here and select this last one and say delete. And you also have, again, the same pattern of the confirmation message to confirm that you want to do this operation. Click OK. And there you have it. The activity was deleted. Now, let me go back into our application to show you one other thing. We've seen in these last couple of lessons, we've seen a couple of patterns to scaffold some screens and some operations in our application. If we search here for scaffold, and let's search on the community, this will lead us to the help of the OutSystems platform. And here on the help, let me just show you the table of contents, you'll notice that there are a couple more patterns that we didn't see here on this application. For instance, you have here a pattern to turn combo boxes into autocomplete widgets. And you have here animated GIF that shows you how to perform this operation. And in all these patterns, there are some requirements for this to work, and you have all this information on the help. So be sure to check the information that you have on the help under the scaffolding a CRUD book. And that's it.